Welcome back. Well, it's been a crazy week weather-wise, Lena. I don't know about you, but one of the nights, the thunder woke me out of my sleep at 2 o'clock in the morning.
I think I got woken up every night, Bree. My sister's pool overflowed yesterday from all the rain from Elsa, and just all the rain this week, right? We've seen a tremendous amount of rainfall in just a few days, and it really did kind of take a toll, throughout
the week. Yeah. And now, even though Tropical Storm Elsa has come and gone, some conditions are still not related to the storm, but are going to be unsettled throughout the week.
Yeah, I mean, we're going to see some shower chances throughout the course of the weekend. I think the weekend is definitely trending a whole lot drier, but we do have some lingering impacts here. We do still have some flood warnings in effect. So wanted to take you through those here. Right now, none in Western Mass, but just off to our east, the Sudbury River at Saxonville does still have a flood warning in effect. Additionally, off to our southeast here, the Blackstone River in Woonsocket does as well. And then just over the border in Connecticut, we have an aerial flood warning. So this one's not really associated with a river or stream, but more so a general vicinity here. That's for Hartford, Tallinn, and Windham. So something to keep in mind if you're heading in those directions for your weekend plans now that we are finally starting to see some sunshine and some drier conditions. That's not all, though. South-facing beaches here, down towards the Cape and the Islands in Massachusetts, also in Rhode Island, we do have dangerous rip currents, and that is in effect through 4 p.m. today. So keep that in mind if you are heading to a coastal area. But like I said, overall, the weekend really is trending a whole lot drier. Now, as we head through the course of the next week, our unsettled weather pattern does continue. We do have several chances for showers, also potential for thunderstorms that we are watching, especially once we get towards the end of the week with the heat and humidity back on the rise, kind of that return of that summer-like feel. So the cold front that brought us showers and thunderstorms overnight is now out to sea and kind of off to our east. Weak high pressure is going to build behind that, keeping us mainly dry today, aside from spotty shower and precipitation chances. But we do have a warm front that's going to approach the region overnight Sunday into Monday. So that brings a chance for the return for more precipitation. And once that comes through, we return to southerly flow. That's when the humidity is really going to be back on the rise. Temperatures for today, right around 80 degrees, especially in the lower valley. Lower 70s up towards Franklin County, also out towards Berkshire County, out in the hill towns and higher terrain. We will see a good amount of sunshine today. And we also are mostly dry with just a light breeze out of the north. Like I said, if it's not rain in buckets like it's been all week, I will take the forecast. Partly cloudy in the overnight hours. We could see some patchy fog developing, especially as we get closer to our dew point. So overnight lows bottoming out between about 58 and 62 degrees, right around where our dew points are sitting right now. And with calm winds, there's nothing to mix that out at the surface. So something to keep in mind if you will be hitting the roadways in the early hours of the morning. Tomorrow, pretty similar setup to today, except for that we have a higher risk for showers, especially as we get into the afternoon and evening. So I do think today is the pick of the weekend, although the temperature profile is roughly the same both days. We see more sun today and we're more guaranteed to stay dry today, aside from that spot shower or sprinkle in the afternoon and evening. So let's time this all out for you on Futurecast. Some locations still hanging onto a good amount of cloud cover here in Western Mass, but most of us right now are dry. The further we get into the afternoon, the more sun we see. You do notice some kind of moisture in the vicinity, so there's your chance for that sprinkle or spot shower. But I think overall at this point, the rain for today is done. Heading into the evening, we will have some cloud cover in the overnight, so partly cloudy skies. We wake up on Sunday to mostly cloudy conditions, and when we get into the afternoon and evening, that's when those spot shower chances really kind of start to creep up, more so later in the day. So if you are looking for time to get outside on Sunday, the morning looks to be the drier bet. Now notice it's not a total washout here. Periods of rain on and off, lingering into the overnight hours. Might see a rumble of thunder in the overnight hours, and then as we head into Monday, looks like things are going to start to get a bit heavier as that warm front pushes through. Looking ahead to the rest of the week, you see multiple chances here for spot showers and spot storms, something we will of course be closely monitoring. Once we get towards the middle part of the week, both temperatures and humidity are on the rise. Now, we've seen a tremendous amount of rainfall over the course of the last week, getting lots of questions on where that stacks up in terms of records. So stick around. I'll see you in a few minutes for all the details on that. Bree, take it away.